By the way, I've been so busy covering all the news, I didn't even tell you that they reinstated the Alex Jones channel. And I want to thank the tens of thousands of calls. They got over 10,000 calls. I talked to somebody I know separately that works at YouTube, high level, but they can't come on record. We did get emails from them saying, why don't you guys file a federal filing challenging these, because it does look like these may be fake. So last week with Dave that runs the channel, we filed in federal court. That's the level we had to go to, is swear in federal court that it was fake, that it was wrong, and it did turn out that there were fake copyright notices. And now the court's looking into who filed them.
Pat Buchanan is connected to him. Yeah. And thus we have Pat Buchanan connected to the Knights of Malta at the highest levels. This also includes Alexander Haig. Pat Buchanan was a dear friend of the Reagan administration. The Reagan administration was absolutely controlled by the Knights of Malta.
Yeah.
Okay? So it's this Pat Buchanan that Alex Jones is having on a regular basis on his program.
But, you know, this is, and folks, I don't think it's going to be up there too long again. They'll just file more criminal deals. I mean, that's what these people do. So we need an evacuation of the Alex Jones channel immediately. There was a lot of subscribers dropped. It was at 40,000. Now it's 37,000. Very bizarre. So, but let's make it even bigger. Everybody should subscribe to it while it's still there. Channel views, 2,975,000.
Laughed a little bit, turned around and walked away. Pat Buchanan will not address anything about the Federal Reserve Bank, because, of course, it's run by the Knights of Malta.
Right.
Particularly, McDonough.
Yeah.
Doug McDonough, he is a CFR member and a Knight of Malta, Irish Roman Catholic. He was the head of the New York Federal Reserve Bank for many years. So Buchanan will not betray his brother Knights. Interesting connection in this 9/11 truth movement.
Yes.
It was by the Knights of Malta. This Daniel Sheehan was a Knight of Malta, and he is... Oh, he was the foremost attorney for the Jesuits Christic Institute, which is a left-wing institute, mentioned by Bo Greitz in his book, Called to Serve. Well, it's this very same of Daniel Sheehan, who is an intimate, dear friend of Alfred Webbery, who, like Alex Jones, is another Jesuit coadjutor, whose uncle was second-in-command of the Jesuit order, according to Webbery himself. And thus, we have the Knights of Malta occupying the entire 9/11 truth movement. And we see, again, the Knights connected to Alex Jones. We've gone a little bit farther here.
I counted up just what it was getting the last week, 2 million, a million the week before that. It was well over 30 million views of the channel. And that's just one channel, but the point is, it was the censorship, but it's a very important channel. So I want folks to get this out to everybody. I want people to go and evacuate the 2,000-plus videos. It was a great loss when it was shut down. We couldn't get the videos off of it because, you know, they're uploaded and they're not on your computer. It took me over a year for Dave working every day just to upload 2,200 and something videos. We have to evacuate everything off of the Alex Jones channel as if they're going to hit it again. We've been having hack attacks, death threats, everything short of monkeys swinging from chandeliers in here. And so this kind of, and a bunch of other channels have been erased and deleted with our stuff. They're attacking everywhere. So I wouldn't count on that site being there very long.
2007, of this year, Jones spoke at the Catholic St. Edward's University.
Eric?
Yes?
Is it possible Sheehan, this lady who's, is there any relationship between her and the Jesuits?
I don't know. That's a very good question. I know she's Roman Catholic.
No.
And maybe there is a connection between her and Daniel Sheehan.
Yeah, maybe her son isn't dead at all.
Yeah, that's a possibility, but she most assuredly is getting the press. I mean, the fascist right-wing Fox News press is giving her plenty of press.
Yeah, and they don't give press to people who really are
genuine
troublemakers or
tumultuous. Right.
Yeah, there's a good chance that she's an agent provocateur.
That's right. So,
by the way, you heard it first here at Cloak and Dagger.
This is the operation. Save that library of material, those interviews, those incredible information. Take the best interviews. You just go pick what you think's most important. Going back over the last year and a half, grab it and put it on your channel. And do it fast.
And what are the provocateurs doing? They're driving the white people of America, Catholic, Protestant, atheist alike, into right-wing fascism. That's what it's all about. Every arrow, every string to their bow is being used to drive the white people into right-wing fascism. And thus, this is what we have here with Alex Jones.
Yeah.
Creating fear and terror against this coming police state. And what are the American people supposed to do? Go right into the arms of the right-wing fascists at Fox News. Another Knights of Malta, which Alex Jones entertains on his program. What we have here with Alex Jones.
Yeah.
creating fear and terror, creating fear and terror, creating fear and terror against this coming police state. And what are the American people supposed to do? Go right into the arms of the right-wing fascists at Fox News and other Knights of Malta, which Alex Jones entertains on his program.